Hey friends, I'm Jake. I'm a developer advocate at Figma. Before this, I was a front-end engineer working on design systems, building out component libraries. I know how easy it can be for design and engineering teams to become misaligned. We waste development cycles in the endless back and forth, clarifying visual details. Even just figuring out what to build can be a challenge. Or we're writing redundant code for things that we know should be reusable patterns. All these things can add up and make for suboptimal and inefficient product development. So we built DevMode to help teams navigate the process of bringing designs to life in code more effectively. Today, I'm going to walk you through some of the ways you and your engineering team can leverage DevMode to accelerate alignment between design and product partners, ensure product quality and consistency through design systems and reusable code, and increase the speed of implementation. We're even going to look at how your development team can stay in the context of their code editor while getting what they need out of Figma. Successful designer and developer collaboration ensures that your engineering team is involved early. They need to have the channels to provide feedback and communicate technical considerations that might influence the design, and you want to do that before anything gets finalized. Let's dive in and take a peek at what that can look like. Figma files usually contain explorations and numerous designs that have seen multiple rounds of iterations with feedback from PMs, designers, engineers, and of course the occasional exec. Somewhere in the sea of screens, there are finalized designs that are ready to be built. Historically, this has made it difficult for developers to quickly find what they need. You don't want your team to have to hunt and peck through a multi-page file to figure out what is in flight, what requires input, and what decisions have solidified and are ready to be built. In dev mode, designers can mark designs as ready for development. This promotes those screens for easier navigation in dev mode, elevating the work that is ready to be built into a more focused browsing experience. This saves engineers having to pan around the infinite canvas, or even worse, having to stop and wait for someone to provide clarity. There can be a scramble during implementation phases where folks realign on decisions that happened in isolation. Our hope is to make it easier for your dev team to participate and be involved in those discussions earlier, and doing this on the web provides an open door into that process. Throughout any part of the process, your team can leverage comments to clarify details or flag technical considerations to the design team that may not be accounted for in the design. We know getting context and communicating with designers is only one small part of a developer's job. The most important part is writing great code. And to do that, understanding various aspects of the design is a key first step. First, designers can leave implementation notes or highlight key measurements on parts of the design with annotations. These will stay attached to objects as the design evolves, so nothing gets lost. It also helps ensure your team is aware of key pieces of functionality, conditional aspects of the design, accessibility notes, or calling out critical dimensions to keep in mind. Next, let's look at layout. Your team needs to understand how designs are structured, the space between elements, and how the design will respond across devices. Selecting elements will surface spacing and padding dimensions across the design. If your team is using a spacing system with design tokens or spacing variables, developers will see the variable names they need to implement so that raw, hard-coded pixel values don't accidentally get implemented. Code snippets will also highlight responsive characteristics, like which elements are fixed or have flexible sizing. Here, we're looking at flexbox properties populated with our team's spacing variables. Your team also needs to understand other visual information, like colors, typography, and which visual assets are being used. Selecting elements in the design will provide info at a glance about the selection. Here you can find colors as hex values or design tokens, as well as typography styles, fonts, weights, sizes, and line heights. When developers need assets like icons as PNGs or SVGs, they don't have to hunt through screens to find them. DevMode detects assets and surfaces them, enabling your team to quickly export them in whatever format they need. We know design is more than a static series of screens, and sometimes a prototype is an easier way for your team to better understand the intended functionality, animation, and sequence of screens. Developers can also view prototypes while in dev mode to get a better feel for the intended design. You can also have the canvas in dev mode follow the active frame so that you can easily find a particular state or screen that you're looking for on the canvas. Despite our best efforts to stay in sync, sometimes last-minute revisions are unavoidable. and you don't want your team combing through messages, scheduling meetings to get context, or worse, discovering a mistake in production and having to add more tickets to their plate to ship bug fixes. Dev mode lets you compare screens with one another or to a past version. This can be viewed visually as an overlay or in a familiar code diff view, making it easier for your team to quickly understand where there are changes, allowing them to continue writing great code. Next, let's talk about product consistency. Design wants a coherent, predictable user experience. And where there's a desire for consistency, there's always going to be an opportunity for reusability. No one wants their team writing redundant code or reinventing the wheel. Design systems allow teams to turn design patterns into reusable ones that are quick for your team to implement in code. This not only makes for a better and consistent user experience, but it saves everyone in your org time when building it. While inspecting designs, developers can easily understand where reusable components are used and also see what library they're a part of. Any component documentation is also surfaced here, along with relevant links to other tools you may be using for developer documentation, such as storybook stories or GitHub repos. A single component can look a lot of different ways, depending on various conditions. Sometimes you need to build a brand new component and need to understand all the permutations of its states and variants. To save your team from wasting time looking for these across the file or inside other files where the components may live, Dev Mode provides developers with a convenient playground where they can explore all the ways a component can look, all without editing the design. Lastly, let's talk about developer efficiency and how you can keep your team focused on the work at hand, which is writing great code. With Dev Mode, Figma's code generation is extensible. You can leverage CodeGen plugins from the community, or develop your own extensions to surface exactly the sort of code you expect. You can also get started quickly and use plugins like the Code Snippet Editor. It enables you to create dynamic code snippet templates for your design system's components so that you can provide your own code to everyone in your org. You can see our component library's code snippets here, already pre-populated with the right prop configurations. We also know development teams rely on other tools to be productive, like Jira, GitHub issues, or Linear for task tracking. Staying on top of those tools can be challenging, and again, often creates a loss of focus to switch tabs into another tool to update or reference a ticket. Plugins in Dev Mode enable your team to get this context and update those issue statuses all without leaving Figma. And lastly, for developers using VS Code, Dev Mode can be experienced right inside your code editor. Write code, inspect designs, respond to comments, copy code snippets, and update tickets, all without wasting valuable dev time moving between tools. I hope this brief walkthrough illustrated how Dev Mode can keep your dev team aligned with design early and throughout the design process, ensure consistency throughout your product, and ultimately save time by making collaboration more efficient. Thanks so much.